वेलकम बैक माई डियर स्टूडेंट ऑन माई यूट्यूब चैनल। आई एम जी डी सर फ्रॉम LPM पब्लिक स्कूल एंड टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू समराइज द चैप्टर गेटिंग फ्यूचर रेडी। एंड बिफोर द समराइज दिस चैप्टर आई वॉन्टेड टू से दैट आई हैव ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन दिस चैप्टर इन द थ्री पार्ट्स। इफ़ यू हैव नो सीन द all three parts, then you go to the my YouTube channel and press the channel icon and then you get all the three videos. Okay, so without wasting our time, we try to summarize the chapter getting future ready, and I hope you all understand how to summarize the chapter in short form. So listen carefully. Here is the getting future ready. Okay, this is the chapter name, and it depend on the scientific invention and technology, and we all know about that the technology and the science also made our life faster, easier and important, convenient. Okay, and here is the some of the quick look at the some of the latest technology offering and sneak peek into what the future hold for us. Okay, in the first part, here is the self-driving car. We can never know or never imagine that there is the self-driving car is provided, and we can also see that the self-driving car as a driverless car or autonomous. But here is the one thing, when nowadays many of the people getting hurt or getting death by the fast running of the vehicles. So here is the scientist of the world create a autonomous, it means driverless car, and it is the completely safe, and many of the software and program are used in this vehicles, and these vehicles make an extraordinary works and features of this vehicles, and this vehicles also has a technology that allow to not only steer the wheel, apply the brake and park the vehicle, but also judge the distance between the vehicles, interpret traffic signal and control speed and gauge traffic and follow specific routes and detect danger. And this driverless car can be seen the pedestrians or the trees falling or the road and slow down or brake, and it also feel the rains. Okay, and turn on the wiper when the rain dropped on the car, and many of the features used in this car. And in the future we know more thing about this car. This self-driving car can help the elderly and those physically challenged move around, and these cars are expected to be safer to use and therefore could reduce the number of the traffic violations and accident. Okay, and in the there are many countries assemble these type of the cars and improve the various version of the cars that have the completely safe for the human being, and soon all these type of the cars will be available among the people. And in the new generation of the car, also thinking driving based car, and that has take no more time. And next we are talking about the human robots. And humanoid robots is a robot which its body shape built resemble the human body. The design may be for the functional purpose such as the interacting with human tools and environmental for the experimental purpose such as the study of bipedal locomotions or other purpose. Okay, and here is the, you can see the image of the Sophia. Sophia is the extra technology used, and she is a robot, and it's is a social robot, a social humanoid robots, and humanoid means a machines that looks and behave like a human being. You know about the human being, beginning of the in the beginning, the robot, when the assemble the robot, that is the not behave like a human, but Sophia has a feature that behave like a human, and he has many of the gesture and emotions, and she also express look like a human being. And this is the activate on 14 February 2016 and revealed the public in March 2016 in Austin, USA. Okay, and Sophia can also expresses or display the 50 facial expressions, imitate the several human gesture, and hold a simple conversation with the person, and she has functional legs too and can talk like a woman. Okay, it structure creating such like that all the activity that looks like a human, and there are huge flavor gives Sophia face a lifelike appearance. It means she looks like a human. You can see here in the figure, her face looks like a human, and she has a eyes, teeth, nose, etc. are the many things, and her face all appearance looks like a human beings. And computer algorithm, okay, and artificial intelligence allow her to recognize the face, voice, and maintain eye contact, and many process of the human speech. Okay, and Sophia was conceptualized by the David Hudson Robotic, most advanced human-like robot. Sophia personifies our dreams for the future of AL. It means AL means artificial intelligence as a unique combination of the science and engineering and artistry. Okay, it means all the three, it means science, engineering, and artistry. It is the creation of the Sophia, and Sophia is the simultaneously a human crafted science facial character depicting the future of the artificial intelligent robotic, and a platform for the advanced robotic and all researches. And the character of the Sophia captured the imagination of the global audience, and she is the world's first robot surgeon and the first robot innovation ambassadors for the United Nations Development Program. Sophia is now a household name, and with the appearance on the Tonight Show and good in editions of the speaking at hundreds of the conferences around the world. It means Sophia attend all in the world. There are more than 100 of the conferences, and Sophia is also a framework for the cutting edge robotic and artificial intelligent research, particularly for the understanding human robot interacting and their potential service and entertainment applications. And Sophia is United Nations Development Program first ever innovation champion. And Sophia popularity indicates that there will be more functional humanoid in the future, and that element of the science fiction may one day become really. And you can see it is the back part of the Sophia, and that is the completely looks like a machine, and in the front part of the Sophia, you can see that looks like a human being. Okay, and the third part is the etiquette of the space, and here you know about the many of the astronaut and the tourist who wanted to go in the space for the wandering or roaming. Before the starting, you know that the astronaut, about the astronaut, an astronaut is a person trained, equipped and displayed by a human spaceflight program to serve an commander of a crew member aboard a spacecraft. Although generally reserved for the professional space travelers, the term are sometimes applied to the anyone who travel into space, including the scientists, politicians, journalists and tourists. And in this chapter you know about that the human have always fascinated by the outer space. And in December 1990, Japanese TV journalist Toihiro Okiano went into the space as a part of the first commercial space flight, and he gave the live report for a week from the Mir space station. Okay, and next, however, the first amateur to pay for a flight into the space for Dennis Tito. And Dennis Tito is an American engineer and businessman, most widely known as the first space tourist to fund his own trip into the space. In mid-2001, he spent nearly 8 days in orbit as a crew member, a visiting mission to the International Space Station. And and here is the Dennis Tito, born on 8 August 1940, and he became the first space tourist or citizen explorer by the visiting the International Space Station. International Space Station, it is the short form of ISS, for 7 days in 2001. After the Dennis Tito, between 2001 and 2009, 6 more people bought a passage to space, and one of them, Charles Simoy, even went twice. Okay, it means Charles Simoy went into space as a twice time. And between 2003 and 2004, two individuals breached the Earth's atmosphere and entered outer space in experimental spacecraft. Several space tourism companies have been formed since then with an aim to facilitate private space exploration for the hefty fees. It means there are many companies provide the facility of the space and environment of the space, create the atmosphere of the space on the Earth, and give the experience of the tourist. But in place of this all condition, they take the hefty fees. It means heavy fees for the civilian. And civilian space program offering zero gravity space flight and short duration space walks are already being offered. Okay, perhaps by the time you grow up, space planes may become a common. It means in the future, when the it means near about 5 or 10 or 15 years later, this space traveling became very easy. Like nowadays, many of the person use the bus and plane for traveling one place to another place. And in the future, the astronaut and the tourist also take the enjoy and pay the fee and buy the ticket टू गो अर्थ टू मार्स, अर्थ टू मून एंड अर्थ टू स्पेस फॉर द ट्रेवलिंग, जस्ट लाइक वी कैन यूज द बस एंड एरोप्लेन्स एंड इट विल बी पॉसिबल एंड मेनी ऑफ द पर्सन विल बी पे द फी एज ए अफोर्डेबल, द फी विल बी अफोर्डेबल फॉर हिम और हर एंड देन यू मे इवन बी एबल टू फ्लाई टू द मून एंड ब्लैक बैक टू द हॉलीडे एंड लाइक यू टेक ए ट्रिप फॉर द स्पेस एंड दिस इज द बेस्ट फॉर अस इन द फ्यूचर. सो दिस इज द समरी ऑफ द चैप्टर. आई होप यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंड दिस चैप्टर वेरी वेल एंड हेयर इज द सम एक्सरसाइज यू कैन सी हेयर. राइट द हार्ड वर्ड ऑफ द चैप्टर. You write down all the hard word from the chapter and read the paragraph carefully and write down the summary of the chapter and then draw a figure of the astronaut or a space tourist. Okay, so I hope you can do it. So it is the summary of the chapter. So thank you for the watching video. Best of luck. Jawle banao.